We're in the middle of a global emergency, and the global emergency needs a global response. The global crisis is not actually due to a simple pandemic. It's due to a syndemic, a synthesis of two epidemics. One epidemic of SARS-CoV-2, but a second epidemic of non-communicable diseases on a background of poverty and inequality.
We've seen the major disruption to services for non-communicable disease and cardiovascular disease and services around the world. We're seeing health workers absent, yes, for infections, and terribly because of deaths.
This is not an inexhaustible resource. Healthcare workers have to be protected, and we also have to look at the number of workers that we need. We need to be able to boost those numbers in our low and middle income countries in particular.
We have about 56 cardiologists in Kenya, and the population is about 54 million. So that means we have one cardiologist for every 1 million Kenyans. So when COVID came, a lot of gaps were revealed. The country had to go into a rapid recruitment of health providers.
COVID-19 has made it clear the strategic importance of healthcare and the need to invest more in our healthcare systems around the world in order for them to become more efficient as well as be better aligned with the realities of health of the global population.
NCDs have to become part of every primary healthcare discussion, every universal healthcare coverage benefit package, and essential interventions have to include the NCDs.
Moving forward, I would like us to train and employ more healthcare workers, improve the infrastructure and resources in the health facilities. Let us also provide an environment that supports the mental health of our healthcare workers. Let the remuneration of the workers be adequate, and let us ensure that we empower primary health structures.
The President, the Prime Ministers need to remain committed to innovative ideas into delivering care and recognizing that it's not just the specialists, the infectious disease doctors, or the ICU doctors, but it is everybody down to at all levels, the community health worker and the public health officials that need support, and we need to be figuring out new ways to bring them together.
Post-COVID, having learned the lessons, some things we would put in place that would be relevant for cardiovascular diseases. Much of the ramping up of training, the logistics, the testing and tracing are applicable to the management of cardiovascular diseases. And what we hope is that these tools, post-COVID, they will be applied to the management of cardiovascular disease.
Public opinion and the voters will judge you, madam or sir, on which side of history you're on. Did you protect the vulnerable from COVID? Did you invest in health, education, and jobs? Which side of history do you wish to be on?